All right, it's that time of year when country music fans in Northern Nevada start thinking about Night in the Country.
Mm-hmm, that's right. The annual music festival kicks off next week, and this year there are a few changes that you might want to know about. Andy Guevara has a look at what to expect.
It's 3 days of music and camping in the farming fields of Yerington. And while the actual campground was not affected by our winter flooding, some of the roadways that get you there were.
In the past, we've used Miller Lane. This year, fans will continue south down to Goldfield Avenue.
The check-in area for camping at the fairgrounds will be the same.
There will be signs out. NHP will be directing traffic.
What you will see once you get there is a repeat from last year, checkpoints. All vehicles coming in are subject to search. Specifically, the amount of alcohol being allowed in is restricted.
So 2 cases of beer and a bulk item per person.
That bulk item refers to the 1 liter of hard alcohol per person limit. Also, everything must be plastic or aluminum, no glass. Anything else can be confiscated. 21 and over wristbands are required. Those will change every day. And there will be plenty of local law enforcement officers and security guards keeping an eye out.
Those who seem to be underage and drinking, and just for fan safety, for patron safety and camper safety.
Okay, how about the fun stuff?
New this year, the stage will come out to the general admission area, providing the general admission fans a closer look or access to our artists.
There will also be an additional Jumbotron and another bar in the general admission area. And next Wednesday, the 26th, a kickoff concert in Reno.
Here at Greater Nevada Field, Whiskey Heroes and Walker Hayes will be performing, and I believe doors open at 6.
Covering the story, Andy Guevara, Channel 2 News.
In case you were wondering, the venue is smoke-free and no marijuana is allowed. Night in the Country does benefit several charities, though, including the Boys and Girls Club of Mason Valley. And there are still tickets available for the festival. For a link, head to our website, ktvn.com, and click on the online version of this story.